think my favorite part of Roderick Rules is when Greg has a sleepover with Rowley, and Manny, Greg's little brother, actually climbs into Rowley's sleeping bag with him. I thought that that was a lot of fun. In the last straw, I think my favorite moment in the last straw is when Greg's father tries to scare him with a picture of Shel Silverstein. I was terrified of Shel Silverstein, who I think is a genius, by the way. You know, he had these pictures on the back of his books, and they were just really terrifying to a kid. Let's see, Dog Days. I think my favorite part of Dog Days is the muddy hand, which is this kind of this ghost story or horror movie that Greg and Rowley see, where there's a disembodied hand crawling around. And I always thought that was pretty funny, that, you know, when a kid sees a scary movie, especially for the first time, and they're not jaded, it can have a huge effect on their life. And let's see, with The Ugly Truth, I think my favorite story in The Ugly Truth is when Greg, he takes some eggs that he eats at a friend's house, and then he can't eat them all, so he actually hides them in a plant, and then the family can't figure out what the smell is, and so eventually they move out, but when they move out, they take the plant with them. So I like that story. And then Diary of a Wimpy Kid, Cabin Fever. I would say my favorite story in this book is I like these the virtual pets that Greg has. He has this virtual pet that's called, what is his name? His name is Gregory's Little Friend. And he has a virtual pet that really needs to be nurtured. And it's this really manipulative website that makes you feel like your pet is suffering if you don't feed it enough coins. So I really like, I took this book in a little bit of a different direction. It's got more satire in it, more social commentary. So each book represents something different to me.